license to kill.
So today you released your new single. Tell us about it.
Don't break my corazón.
Yeah, that's the title.
Spanish.
Yeah. So it's actually was one of the first demos that we recorded and did well, starting to do the third album back at that time 2 years ago when we had released Mercury and Glitter and kind of stopped with that and promoted it, and everybody started to feel they want to take a little break and we sort of traveled a lot, everybody traveled with themselves and with buddies and so we sort of like spread around the globe and everybody was in different places and the title of Don't Break My Corazon was actually a sentence that Mikko overheard in Argentina and also in some bar or something.
There was a,
I guess it must have been like an English guy or something and he was hanging out with local girl and he just overheard like those girls over there sort of like just one sentence, please don't break my corazon. And it was sort of like a funny thing to say and it stuck with his mind and when he came back he pictured it as for us then start to evolve.
Yeah, and we actually made the song twice.
Yeah, that's true.
The first version wasn't quite the hits now.
Yeah. Or there was some stuff still that sounded too much like the second album, and we wanted the third album to be a pretty much different case. So therefore, we did it twice. And I remember thinking that if you're gonna do every song twice with this album, it's gonna take like a decade, 10 years, 8 years to get it done. But hopefully that was the only one, but it paid off.
And this song sounds like modern talking.
Yeah, everybody keeps saying that, and it's true. it was an old thing when we did it. We wanted it to be a sort of like a have a lot of 80s flavor to it, 80s pop, certain pop flavor to it, but in a modern sense. And there's also like pretty much a danceability to it, and, almost like some old video games, rhythmic stuff from like Commodore 64 game music, something like that. Our producer, Sami Baldock, really went nuts with the song, and it has some, well, at least 80s flavor. Yeah, modern talking, I'll give you that. Yeah.
And what's the idea behind the video?
The video's idea is behind. It came from Sami Joensuu, the guy who directed it, and I guess it's like an MO is to have like these old guys doing something weird in his music videos, and therefore it's
almost like a documentary.
Yes, yeah. So there's always when Sami is doing something, at least pretty often there's a band and there's an old man, Finnish man, or and it was actually a fun thing to shoot because the time frame was so narrow. We shot it. It was like the last days before Christmas, and we had like one day, and fortunately everybody was okay with it, and it was pretty quick to shoot. We did it in like 4 hours or something. We're used to doing like 12 hours, 15 hours days of music video shooting. For some reason, it's always like that. It's fun stuff, but it usually takes its time.
Yeah. Easy and funny day.
Yes.
When your new album is gonna be out?
Hopefully in May. It also depends, of course, how the first single turns out, and the reviews have been quite good. Actually, it's been only this day, but I've been getting text messages and emails and stuff that people really complimenting the song, and they seem to like it a lot. So if all goes well, it'll be released in beginning of May in Finland and then in Germany, Switzerland, and Austria in somewhere in the middle of May or something. but in a couple of months.
And today you start your new tour with Sunrise Avenue.
Yeah.
What do you expect?
A whole lot of fun.
Yeah,
and
that's for sure.
Loud music. We sort of go way back with those guys, at least some of them. Osmo, who is now playing keyboards pretty regularly with them, is a old, like a singer buddy of mine. We have been doing gigs a few years back in Europe, and also Raul, the bassist, is an old friend of ours from the school. We sort of hooked up and started this band. I remember seeing those guys doing their own stuff like 10 years ago.
Yeah. Raul was my first band teacher, actually.
You shouldn't say that. It gives him some like an older guy vibe. But it'll be fun. We've been a couple of times with them in Germany in past few years, and it's always been so much fun. It's great, of course, to do like big venues, 6,000 or 7,000 people arenas, and now they're going to be even bigger this time. So, and now it's going to be a tour, so we're pretty psyched about it. And a lot of things just want to get their attention to this specific day. There's a tour starting in an hour or hour and a half or so, and next Wednesday we're off to Zurich, and then it starts there.
Yeah, I wanted to go to Zurich, when the date was another.
Sorry?
I was going to go to Zurich,
yeah,
but they changed the date.
Okay.
I still have my ticket.
You still have the ticket?
Yeah. But I'm going to Vienna.
Okay, well, we'll see you there.
Yeah. And I remember your comments about your last tour, about my worst band.
Yeah, the guys in Sunrise Avenue were really tough on us. So the first time when we went to Germany, I recall it was in Hamburg.
Yeah. Hamburg, yeah. And the same guy was going to be our tour manager.
Who was greeted us firstly when we came to the venue almost 2.5 years ago. He had this like German military outfit on, and he spoke only German, pretty loud. And I didn't get to see that. You were on the first. Were you there?
The first. He took us to our dressing room,
yeah,
which was a small booth with two bottles of water.
And the towel.
Yeah. And, it's like a gym locker or something. And, on the door it said my worst band, or that's sort of the sense of humor they attempt to keep in Sunrise. Of course it's like a brotherly fun and gag.
So you travel to Germany, Switzerland and Austria.
Yeah.
Where do you want to go else?
I'd say anywhere else, everywhere, because we've been doing this stuff sort of long now, 2 albums in Finland only, and when a band decides to make lyrics in English, it's sort of always, whether you wanted it or not, it's always a thing that's written in the concept that you'll be able to perform the songs worldwide. So of course it's something that we've been striving for, and now it's a big level change for us to finally go in Central Europe with them. Also, would be nice to tour around Scandinavia, UK, Russia, the States, of course, everywhere. I heard there's a party going on in China now. So.
Yeah, pretty much Finnish bands come to China.
Yeah, actually we had a couple of buddies of ours, this psychedelic rock and roll combo called Knucklebone Oscar. They went to China a couple of years back, and they filmed a movie about it, which was pretty intense looking touring in China. A lot of things is different, hopefully there. So it would be nice to, well, a whole new country is always a whole new country. Different type of people in there. different cultures and different way of acting and being on gigs, and it's always cool. So I love the German audience specifically. Very heartwarming people.
And what was your most memorable event?
In doing gigs.
Yeah.
I guess for me, it must have been the gig in Hamburg a couple of years back. It was really a game changer for us.
We didn't know what to expect. The venue was huge.
Yeah. It was so big, and we already knew, we had heard the news and we had heard the rumors that Sunrise Avenue is a pretty big band in Central Europe, in Germany and other German-speaking countries. But we still didn't know what to expect. But I remember looking at the people coming in like 1 hour before, right away when the doors opened, there's still 1 hour to go for our gig, and people start to come in and they're squeezing themselves on the front of the stage, and I start to think that, well, this is going to be the biggest gig that I've ever been to. It was so great. I don't remember much of it. And when things go so big and you have so much fun and it's so energetic, you sort of like come back to reality after the gig has been played. Then you're at the back room and backstage and think, what happened? I don't know if it's something about playing music to people and touring a lot and traveling a lot. Stuff happens to us, and when it happens, it sucks into our heads, and out of it comes lyrics. And on Corazon, the third album, which is coming up, it's different in a way on the previous albums, that everybody in the band wrote lyrics. Lots of songs from Juho, lots of songs and lyrics from Juho and Heikki and Mikko and the drummer Heikki.
And also our producer Sami Valta participated in the songwriting process.
Yeah, so we wanted to, my first band, to be a sort of a vessel to give everyone a chance in the band and in the process to write stuff out and make songs out. And if the songs make the cut and they would be as good as they would make the album. But everybody participated in the songwriting, so if you have pitched an idea, for instance, there's a cool track on the forthcoming album called Thank You for Your Heart, which is sort of a story of a black market organ trading. With a twist, for some reason he had that kind of an idea for a pop song, and we start to think, well, can we pull this off? Could there be a pop song telling a story of people losing their internal organs and sold in black markets? Well, there can be a song, and I'd say it's a pretty good one. So.
And the third album is pretty much inspired traveling,
yeah,
like you said before. There's songs from Asia, South America,
yeah,
Europe.
Yeah, and USA also. Because I guess back at that time, when I think about it now, there was lots of things happening in our personal lives. Lots of I don't go into the details, but relationship stuff and stuff that everybody has to deal with at some point, and out of those experiences came a lot of lyrics. I guess we wrote over like 50 or 60 songs for the album, and only 11 or something made the cut. It's always a big thing to write songs to a new album. It took us like 1.5 years and then another year for recording.
Let's talk about your fans. How do you communicate with them?
Well, it has always been fun, especially on the bigger venues, to go to do sort of a meet and greet over the merchandise desk or some over there after the gigs. So we're definitely gonna do that also now on this forthcoming tour. And also we just gotten pretty active in Instagram and Facebook, and we get, even now we started to get pretty much of messages and stuff like that. And
we opened a new internet site today.
Yeah, I try to read all the messages, but I don't have the time to reply everybody personally. So I started to keep a blog, and I try to write the answers and stuff that is concerning our fans over there. So it's just starting up. I just my first entry on the blog today. So.
And what do you want to say to your fans, especially the Russian fans?
Our Russian fans, that's a territory that hasn't been so active to us just yet. Yeah, I really hope that at some point, pretty soon, we'll be able to do a gig in St. Petersburg or Moscow, or even do a tour in Russia. I heard great things while speaking on the subject, when Sunrise Avenue was touring in Russia and Eastern Europe. Great things and cool stories about those trips, and instantly thought that, well, this is some place that we have to do with my first band. The first break we have, when we have the opportunity to go to Eastern Europe and Russia, we're definitely going to do it. So I hope the fans will be patient, and I hope they'll be able to get some of our material, music and music videos from the internet, and join our Facebook and be active in there, because we're the people that represent us get the feel that there are fans also in Russia. If they're active, they can see it, and then we'll start turning, and hopefully we'll be in Russia in no time.
By the way, pretty much Russian fans coming to Sunrise Avenue gigs in Helsinki, and they're going to Europe, so they will see you.
Okay, great.
Especially I heard that pretty much Russian people will be today.
Okay.
I saw them at the doors.
Okay, hey, that's cool to hear. Now, it was fun to see that there are already like a queue lining up in front of the venue. So I think it's going to be a hard night for us today.
And by the way, why does your band called My First Band? Is it the first band for you?
Actually, it's the first band for me. there's that touch of reality there. All the other guys, you had bands back in, it was almost a millennium when we started playing together, 1998 or something. And you had been playing with bands and together, you and Heikkis and. Yeah, but it was the first band for me. We sort of hooked up in high school, which was sort of like music, active in music, and formed a band. And by that time, I sang all the time, but I really hadn't been thinking about singing in bands. But I don't know if this might sound sort of like I'm making stuff up, but I remember thinking that way back then, 15 years ago or 14 years ago, when we started to play, well, we fought a pretty lot back then, especially me and my drummer Heikki. We sort of didn't sort of see eye to eye every now and then, but we got that settled then. But I kept thinking that this is a nice group to do stuff together, and playing music and making music and making songs and making the first demos for guys who are 17 or 18 years old, 16 years old, it's a big deal. It was so important to us. We used to do it all the time, and we still do it all the time. So in a way, nothing has changed from those days.
About the name My First Band, we also want to remind ourselves of the first time we took a guitar, yeah, or drumsticks in our hand, and we want to remember that feeling over and over again.
Yeah, especially when you're a kid or when you're a young guy and you don't know, you have all this energy but you don't know how to, where to put it. And we have been putting it into music since 1997, yeah, and keep doing it until, yeah, for as long as I hope.
And do you want it will be your last band?
I would like it to be in our last band. I've always looked up to like Rolling Stones and the really old bands. I don't know if there's that much of a coolness to Rolling Stones doing their like gazillion comeback tour all over again year after year, but I can understand the guys. I can understand why they do it. Of course the money must be an issue for them also, but playing music is fun, even if you played like a couple of chords with those certain guys and certain songs. It's always like, for instance, we did today a soundcheck song called Broken Day, which is one of the oldest songs that we had, which on the first album, first single out there. And it always sounds so great to my ears. It's always so fun. And I kept thinking that you can't replace anybody in this band. If you replace, then the whole stuff would sound a little bit different. And therefore, there's always magic. At least for me, when we play together.
That's all. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.